video we've recorded earlier. It's on the topic of incest. It's just talking about kind of why you should do it and why you shouldn't do it. And you may be wondering, why is a video about Inktober coming out practically at the start of December? Well, originally this video was going to be an actual tour for a sketchbook, but that didn't turn out quite so well as, well, Premiere Pro did not want to load that at all. So, what this ended up being is kind of a speed paint of one of my Inktober drawings. This was actually day 30, which I think was found. So it was kind of based around the show Dev Gently and all the kind of characters that got found in it. And I'm just going to talk about what Inktober is, why you might want to do it, what kind of experience I had, and kind of look at some pieces I did. And kind of a way to kind of boost my confidence and talk about art in general. So what exactly is Inktober? Well, Inktober is a prompt challenge that goes along for the entire month of October. Sorry, I'm posting this video pretty late, but well, I've explained already. It was created by Jacob Paul, who is an artist. It's where you do one drawing a day for the entire month. It was originally created in 2009, so I didn't know. Actually, it's got quite a long history. It's been going on for a while now. I've only done Inktober twice. I did it once this year, and then I attempted it last year. I say attempted because I only really did very small drawings. They weren't kind of full page illustrations. I kind of cheated a little bit, but getting on site can't really cheat Inktober. It's just about upkill. It was originally developed by the artist so that he could develop positive drawing habits, which is pretty interesting. When you think of kind of positive drawing habits, you don't really think of drawing every day. You might think about just drawing regularly or with a regular schedule. But I found that drawing every day actually helped me to improve my style and make myself experiment more. So the rules of Inktober is that, one, you have to make a drawing that uses ink. It doesn't necessarily have to be kind of straight from imagination. You can sketch, you can use pencils to kind of plan out the drawing you want. But the final illustration has to at least have had some kind of influence by ink. So whether that's drawing inks or pens or pens. Calligraphy, it could be typography. I recently had someone follow me who had this cool like typography illustration, and I couldn't understand how they got kind of like idea from the prompts. It would be like juicy, and then they've done kind of this gripping text. It was amazing. But it doesn't necessarily have to be a drawing of a picture. It could be text, it could be anything. But you make a drawing in ink or using ink. You post it online, so that could be on any kind of social media. I posted mine mainly on Instagram because that's a picture sharing website, and it was actually pretty prevalent on Instagram. And then you post it with a hashtag Inktober, which is ink and then October, or Inktober and then whatever year you are participating in. So mine was 2017, and then you repeat that every day for the entire month of October. If you're interested in next year, I would recommend kind of going a couple months before October or a month before October and checking out the official website. It has prompts, what prompts are going to be on, what kind of things to expect, and it can also help if you want to plan ahead like I did. I bought a sketchbook slightly before the start of October and wrote down all the prompts on the inside of the book so that I could just pick up the book and go straight into it. So you may be asking, why would you want to do Inktober? I wanted to do it because I wanted to challenge myself. I found that most of my illustrations, I'm not a sketchbooky kind of person, but most of my illustrations were very small. They didn't take up a large portion of space on the page. I kind of felt like I was wasting the sketchbooks if I did more than kind of like a corner. So I would literally just draw in the smallest little space in the sketchbook and leave so much empty page. So one of the first illustrations I did, I actually forced myself to fill the entire page of illustration. So I actually did a piece that was a mermaid, and the prop was swift, so I chose to do swift like a coursing river, a very kind of posh kind of quote, but then just draw like this very liquidy looking mermaid with this kind of abstract look at the prompt. And that's good as well because you don't have to stick strictly to the prompt. There's a lot of crossovers with different challenges. Like I remember there was a lot of crossovers between Inktober and the witch prompts. So people were drawing witches and then adding in little things like swift, might be someone flying through the sky kind of very quickly. You can experiment a lot with the prompts, but my whole thing was I wanted to fill more space, leave less negative space, and kind of challenge myself. So you could try new mediums as well. Like, I tried out a lot of ink supplies that I never even attempted before. I'm a very digital artist. I do a lot of kind of speed paints and videos like that, and I focus very much in things like Photoshop and paint and style, and I never touched ink. I was barely a skillful person. But I found that trying new mediums like Winsor & Newton inks, trying out using a brush instead of using a pen, you can get quite a lot of different effects, or just kind of dripping ink onto a page and kind of, it's very good for being art blocks. I found about halfway through the month I got in a really big rut and I just didn't know what I wanted to draw, and just stepping back and like looking at a book, looking at a magazine, and actually going through the hashtag and looking at everybody else's art really helped me to just pin down what I wanted to draw or what kind of style I wanted to go for. I actually had one character that I drew in one illustration, and then the next illustration on, like a couple days later, I ended up drawing them again because I really wanted to develop the character more. And this is just a random character from the prompt. I think it was from the prompt Shy. And then I started drawing her over and over again. And she's a character that I actually want to develop further, so I might develop her digitally even more. And yeah, so it's pretty good at breaking an artist block or breaking a creativity block. If you're stuck there and you can't figure out what you want to draw, look through the hashtag, look through what other people are drawing, see how they're reflecting to the prompt, and just attempt different things. Try different mediums you want to work with, try different challenges, and just have fun with it. That's the main thing. It's not a challenge for everyone. It's not something that every artist is going to enjoy 100%. Sure, there were some days where I was like, why am I doing this? This is so annoying. I've got to post this today. But at the very end, having this sketchbook that was almost entirely full of just original illustrations was amazing. It really boosted my confidence when it came to just drawing in general. And it's helped with this as well. I mean, I scanned in this drawing and now I'm calling it digitally. It's crossing over kind of the digital and traditional. So it's really helped me to kind of combine my work and just make me more confident in general. I'm repeating myself now, so I'm just going to let the kind of speed paint play on till the very end. I'll probably put up some of my favourite pieces and kind of annotate on screen why I like them or why I think they're so successful. But this has been a little talk about in total. I hope it's been helpful. If there is any questions about supplies or about any of the illustrations, please leave a comment. And all of my illustrations from October are on my Instagram that I'll leave a link for in the description of the video. So I hope you enjoyed the rest of the speed paint, and thank you so much for watching. We'll be right back.
Thank you.